This small controller can change the whole market in 2021. Newest FlipSky 7550. This is literally one of the best controllers which you can buy today. First thing which you notice, this controller seems to be quite small, because it is crazy small. Actually, all those VECs are small. As a comparison here, I've got controller from Boyda 45 amps, which you know quite well. And actually, there is nothing to compare. As you can see, FlipSky is way smaller. Check this one out. FlipSky seems to be like 5 times smaller. Yep, it's way smaller, but it doesn't mean that it's less powerful. This thing can handle up to 50 amps as a constant and over 100 amps in peak. And it could be true, because all VECs are quite powerful. Also, this one can handle from 3 to 16S, so to around 75 volts, so this is like pocket beast. Next big difference is that all those VECs are way more advanced compared to the simple controllers which we can find in e-bikes and e-scooters. This one is like Tesla. We've got a dedicated app for the smartphone and for the PC. In this app we've got so many options. You will spend like a couple weeks to check every single of them and understand them. So I will not go today through all those options, because this is just simple overview. But I think the most important which I have to mention is that we've got audio tune for the motor, because not every single motor is the same. Motors got different amount of magnets, coils, and thanks to this auto tune, this VC will check what is the best configuration for the motor. So you can expect that after tune you can achieve better power, better working range, and motor will heat up less. I know that it sounds quite crazy that with the same amount of power you can feel more power and making better working range. Yes, it's quite possible thanks to VEC. Next one is number of ports, and as you can see over here we've got plenty of those. Of course, more ports means that we've got more possibilities, because we can connect more things to the controller. And yeah, here we've got a lot. But I think the most important one is this one. This is UART. Thanks to this port, we can control some simple analog throttle or brake lever. So we can even connect over here levers from the Xiaomi N365. Also, we can connect to this port Bluetooth module. So thanks to it, we can connect this controller to our smartphone. And there is dedicated application, and we've got almost the same options like on PC application, so we can change any kind of aspect of this controller in real time. Also, there is this special thing, no idea how to call it, but you can see in real time how many power you are using, how fast you are going, how much power is going back to the battery. So this is pretty crazy. But let's back to the business. Also, to UART, we can connect that kind of LCD screen. Thanks to it, we can follow in real time how fast we are going, how much juice left in the battery, or how much juice we're using actually, like watts or amps. Looks quite nice. On the back we've got 3 extra buttons, so we are able to change some settings. And this is good idea if you don't like to use your smartphone outside, because if you crash, if you drop the smartphone, then it could be quite expensive. But also this thing is not very cheap. It costs like $50, and I had to buy a couple of them because I've got big plans for this channel. So if you are not a subscriber, I recommend to subscribe, because more amazing stuff is coming. Here we got some extra ports. This one is for Hall sensor, so if we'll connect our motor to it, we can expect that the ride will be super smooth, because controller will know at what position is motor shaft. Thanks to PPM input, we can connect simple RC car remote, so this one with the throttle like this and the brake like this, and control this thing. So it's quite crazy, but it's even better. We can connect two controllers together. So let's say that you are building a scooter and you want this controller to power up the rear motor and this one to power up the front motor. So you can do it easy, just connect those two ports together, set right thing in the application, and it's pretty done. It will work. And actually in the application you will see how much power is using each controller, or you can see some of both. So this is pretty insane. That's why I love VHC, because we've got so many possibilities. Also, we can connect Arduino to this controller, of course, by using UART. And you can program Arduino like when you hit the brake button, then the rear lights will start to blink. When you hit the throttle, then some extra LEDs under the deck will start to flow. So there is so many possibilities. Just your imagination can stop you. But yeah, thanks to this stuff, your mind will level up, and there is so many options. So like I said, I will not go through every single of them, but in future videos, I will show you how to easily mount this VHC in your scooter. So to replace this old big ones to something amazing like this, I will try to do it the simplest way as possible. Maybe I will even do tutorial on my website. To be honest, I cannot wait for this adventure to change old controller to newest VHC, because if my TI-30 will be more powerful, I will achieve better working range than bros. This is it. Actually, I've got a plan to set 50 amps per motor as a constant and 75 amps in a peak, so we can expect that the wheels will all the time slip over the ground due to bigger power. So what could go wrong? Actually, what could go right? The scooter will not go boom, but will it? We'll see it in next episode. It will be fun, bros, for sure.